Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. I'm coming with another page makeover page of this journal, large journal. I made like one of my first ones and it's sewn really well, so I'm not gonna disturb the pages. I'm gonna just make them over. This was that first page I have started in that first video. So I'm gonna move to this page and I choose from my scrapbooking layouts this side to somehow recreate it. Probably not with this one because it's too short space here and I don't wanna extend it on this page. But I choose this one and this is Happily Ever After by, I think, Donna Tartar probably. Probably Donna Tartar. This print, it's terrible. It's like blurry, but I think it's Donna Tartar. So Happily Ever After by Donna Tartar. And as you can see in that journal, I have made this napkin technique that decoupage on this pocket with napkin technique. And I don't want to take it off because I will destroy all that page. So, and if I will put it all together with this, it will be just too much, those colors. They will be like too many colors, so I need to calm it down. I chose the white paint and I put somewhere the brush. I just lost the brush I chose for this technique. Oh, there you are. I'm gonna use this brush and I will try that. If I will have a chance to open it, I will try that dry brush technique. Hopefully that will go well. And then to do some decorating, which will somehow end it in this kind of layout here. We will see. I do have something prepared. I'm not sure if that will work properly. So I'm gonna just very carefully. I don't wanna paint it totally with that white color. I just wanna have that vanished effect. So really with nearly dry brush and I applied a little bit of that white color here. Now here we go. Just a little bit calm down those I think I'm gonna keep the queen as she is. Just these colors a little bit calm down. And I think maybe a little bit more here. Okay. Yes. And I hope that you all are doing well. It's beautiful weather outside, so I'm gonna move back to my garden and try to continue with my garden, which I do, but very slowly. Like very slowly. More I do enjoy to spend, you know, time in there with my dog. So he's fetching his toys while I am just lazy. And I call it gardening. That's good gardening. So I think I'm gonna call it done for now. I'm gonna try to dry this a little bit to make sure that I can glue my pockets on it. episode. And I will try now, if that will be possible, just to go over the edge. I'm using tea dye, distress ink. This one, it's pretty much old and dry. It's just, you know, I'm taking those last inks out of this ink pad. Okay. Yeah, it's nothing there. It's like really dry. Just to make shape all around, and maybe I can put there a little bit of walnut stain. Like this, a little bit of walnut stain here on this edge, not too much. I don't want to make it dark, dark. And now about those layouts. So, when I saw this layout, I was thinking that these pieces, they look like tabs. So I already prepared my book of tabs. It has 6 tabs exactly like here on this, which I will just slide in it, and they are made very easy. Just 6 pads or 6 papers with different position of that tab made in the book, so there can be right from both sides. They can be used like a journal from both sides, and all together it makes beautiful tapped notepad. So that will be slide inside like this. It's nearly there. I made it a little bit bigger. So I've got this one, and then for here, I choose just opening, and to somehow match it together, put it together, I made small tab here. So first, I think I'm gonna glue this one. And I hope, because here is that paint, that my glue will glue it properly. I'm gonna put glue on 3 sides, not on 2. On 3 sides, not on 4, not on 2, on 3 sides, and make just entry from one side, in case that I will wanna place there some tack. So I'm gonna place it right here, like this, and I will hope that it will dry so it can be open its pocket here, and then once it will dry, hopefully it will dry properly. There will be pocket from here, and I did make this beautiful metal frame for that gorgeous picture from France. And on the top, when I saw that layout, I was thinking that totally reminds me when I made a tutorial a while ago. I think 2 years ago I made a tutorial for hidden pocket, when you had to slide that top and it was open your pocket. So I've got it here prepared. I use this time this beautiful picture, so I'm gonna again just glue it down. Glue it on my page. I think here, and let it dry. Is it straight? To make sure. But it's straight. First I need to let it dry, then we can open the pocket. So I'm gonna let it dry properly to make sure that I can lift it up. Not lift it up, like move this panel. And before I will put there that notepad, I was thinking to do also something on that next page. I don't wanna make pockets on every single pages. I wanna keep some pages for writing, and especially this one, it's beautiful. It's not destroy, like this page will need some of my touches, because here is a hole, so I will think about it. But for this page, I was thinking I'm gonna keep it for writing. I'm not gonna do anything at all on it, but I would like to decorate it somehow. So what I did, I made tutorial not long time ago, when I found in my books how in 1910 they made from newspaper transparent images. So I used that technique with beeswax, and I have created this lift up page, and I'm gonna use this panel to glue it on this writing space. So, and I will use this as well, like a tuck spot. And I was thinking about this layout, or this lift up page, when I saw another scrapbook layout. I will show you immediately. I didn't do it till the exactly point, but I try to keep some of these ideas. Just bear with me. I'm gonna place it on that bright spot like this. Press it and let it dry. So I was thinking about something like this when I saw this one, this layout. I was thinking how I can do it. First I was thinking I'm gonna do some pocket, but then I was thinking this looks like tab, and this I don't have to have there everything. So instead of this banner, I've got here those strings. And I've got hanging picture. I accidentally placed it on the other side. It should be here. I know it's not circle like here, but it is. At least it's there. I've got the title here, Moments in Time. And this I have created on my computer. Those images are from my book I've got. And I just created this layout exactly for this beeswax technique, because I think it will be wonderful. Once you will write something underneath, I'm gonna just place that this one so you can see. So it will be seen. Everything what you can write down on that page, it can be seen later on, you know, through that paper. And I think it will be beautiful. So I did choose this one. So here we will have that lift up page. And I'm gonna have a look if we did glued, get glued. Hey. Is it holding well? Are you holding well? You know, to make over the journal you already made, I think it's so much fun. I know I don't want to destroy this journal, not at all, because I kind of like how I made it. I just want to add what I learned from all those, from that time when I made this one. So I would like to add there the things I learned from all YouTubers, all that craft family here, and from all those bloggers, from Tim Holtz, you know, from all those channels I'm watching. So here we have, I don't want to lift it yet too much, because I'm not sure how great it is. I think I will need to wait properly to let it dry. But then once it dries, this can be moved. Hey, come on Gil, to this side, and we have pocket here is pocket for tuck, and then it can be moved to other side and you don't see that pocket. But I don't wanna move it too much, because you know it's not flat, beautiful flat background. So here that glue needs to get through all those waves and wrinkles. So this is my very quick sharing for today. So here I have created another layout, and yeah, this layout is just another day in paradise, and I think it's Janine McBride. I'm sorry, it did print really terribly, this Janine McBride. It looks that way. Just another day in paradise, name of this beautiful layout. So, and I can honestly say I do enjoy it, that making making pages using those layouts, it's so much easier. You know, you don't have to stress out too much. And it's really easy, kind of easy. So, these are my another two pages for this journal. I hope you got some idea how to translate for yourself some scrapbooking layout to make over your journal or make over some old book. And hopefully I will see you in the next part. Thank you so, so much for visiting my channel today. Have a wonderful time. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.